So that is the goal of this. We're going to test the cooling solutions with a mixture of hardware inside of there and also a mixture of loads. We also want to test redundancy across that. We start at 2N, then we go to N plus 1 and N, and see what kind of losses you have from an efficiency standpoint. On top of that, we want to have a mixture of hardware. Sun hardware, we'd love to have IBM and Dell and HP and others involved in it, but this isn't for us to go back and do a bake-off against the actual computer manufacturer's equipment. What we want is the mixture of equipment, because that's the reality of what happens in data centers. You buy technology, the next time you may not buy that vendor, you buy something else. And they may have a different delta T, they may have a different power factor, they may have a different plug. All those components add up to what the data center really looks like. So having that hardware in there would be great, that mixture of that hardware. On top of that, we want to go back and meter. And we want to find out at what level we should be actually measuring things, and at what granularity we should. How much should be in there, and where should we be testing, and what devices should we actually be counting on for that testing. So we're going to be measuring, of course, the primary PDU. We're going to be measuring down at the rack PDU. Every one of the two different rack PDUs will be individually monitored, metered, and switched, so I can go back and now see the outlet reading from that. And then, of course, we want to have the sensors and the servers to see exactly what they're expecting from the power. And then on the other side, we want temp and humidity. So we want to use, of course, the servers themselves as far as what they're sensing. We want to take these wireless sensors. We want to take other environmental monitoring units. We want to take the cooling units and their chilled water inflow meters and that type of thing, and really understand what it is that's happening. But the big thing is, how much metering should I put out there, and at what granularity? Which ones work the best? And how much do I really need to go back and look at? We're also going to insert a bunch of failures inside of this. Things that happen on a day-to-day basis with data center operations. You're replacing servers. You've got some system that shuts off. You've got holes in your hot aisle containment. You have things that move around. We want to insert those failures inside of there and see what happens. On top of it, you've got prediction technologies. And so CFD modeling, computational fluid dynamics, you see where the airflow is supposed to be going. We want to do those calcs, and then we want to actually see how it operates within these tests to see how accurate those CFD models are. Then on the last part of that is, what's on top of all this? What's the workload? We've got a bunch of heaters, which are the computer manufacturers, but we want to put some real workload on top of that equipment, not just simulations. So eBay has signed up to simulate their actual auctions, their cyclical auction patterns within here. We're also looking, we've got one of the big banks interested in doing this around high performance computing, and we're considering other aspects that we can actually land on top of this to have it more of a realistic thing. Because if you've got a mixture of storage and hardware and network within the configuration from multiple vendors, and you're running different work jobs, as long as we can replicate that each time across the different solutions, we should have some pretty interesting results. So that's the stack. It's a pretty aggressive undertaking. We're kicking off next week, and with all the different vendors. We're going to be doing the testing, all the prep work and everything up for the testing all the way through into February. Starting in February, we'll be doing the testing itself. And the goal is that we will have everything finished up, and in September of 2009, all these results will be presented. Now, what you can expect from Data Center Pulse in this podcast. We're going to give you frequent updates on this because I really care about this. I'm championing this effort within Sun. We're funding a lot of these pieces just to enable the test to happen. But we are just a participant, just a host, and Lawrence Berkeley National Labs and Silicon Valley Leadership Group are the ones that are actually running everything within it. They're making the decisions around it. We're helping with all the testing parameters, get everyone agreeing on what it is that's going to be tested, and then we hand it off and LBNL actually does the work. So you'll be getting that. I'm going to be interviewing the different participants within the actual test itself. You'll be getting on-site tours of what's going on and seeing the progress of what's going on in the chill-off itself. So I think it should be a pretty good segment. So please stay tuned, and thanks again for watching Data Center Pulse. Bring the beat back. Pump the beat now.